Hello everyone, and welcome back to another exciting chess game from the history of chess. And in this chess game, White is Jose Raul Capablanca, and his opponent is Frederick Thomas Downey. And this game was played in London, England, in 1911, in a simultaneous exhibition, when Capablanca was against 26 different opponents at the same time. We already checked out a different chess game of Capablanca from a different simultaneous exhibition, but that was in Birmingham, but in same year. Probably Capablanca was visiting chess clubs one after another and playing massive simultaneous exhibitions. So in this chess game, Capablanca has the white pieces and he starts the game with playing e4, e5, d4, e takes on d4, and we have the Danish gambit. The Danish gambit, c3, d takes on c3, and bishop to c4. Black is going all the way, c takes on b2, showing no respect to Capablanca. After c takes on b2, bishop takes on b2, d6, queen to b3, attacking the f-pawn, defending with the knight, and knight to f3, knight to c6. What a wild chess game already. We rarely see the Danish gambit in modern times, in the 21st century. So after knight to c6, Capablanca castled, bishop to d7, and queen to c2. We have queen to e7, and knight to c3. And black also castled, castling into it. As you can see, the queen is stalking the king, eyeing the king. Again, once again, Frederick Thomas Downey shows no respect to Capablanca. He has no fear. After knight to d5, defending the queen. But rook from f to c1. Not just the queen is aiming the king, but also the rook is aiming the king. This doesn't look very good for black. This looks risky. At one point, black can crack under the pressure. So after f6, we have knight to c3, knight to g4, knight to b5, queen to h5, h3, and defending the knight. Capablanca captured the knight. Bishop takes on e5. D takes on e5. And this is the point. This is the moment. When black cracked under the pressure, what would you do in this position? It is white to move. How to attack? Can you see the crushing move, the bone-crushing attack by Capablanca? Well, in this position, Capablanca captured the pawn. Knight takes on h7. Capturing the pawn with the knight. Knight takes on a7. And moving the king, but not capturing the knight. Well, Capablanca is also sacrificing the knight. But black didn't capture the knight. If in this position, if capturing the knight, knight takes on a7. Can you see the continuation? Well, then we have bishop to f7. This brilliant move. With a double threat. Threatening checkmate. And attacking the queen. Black can't defend everything. If pushing the pawn, defending the queen, then queen takes on c7. Checkmate. There is no defense. And black is getting checkmated. Let's take it back. Capturing the bishop is not changing anything because we still have queen takes on c7. Checkmate. There is no defense. And black is getting checkmated with a crushing pawn. Let's take it back. And in this position, if defending the checkmate threat, if blocking the queen with the knight, then bishop takes on h5. And once again, black is losing, white is winning. So this is why, in this position, Capablanca captured the pawn, knight takes on h7, king to b8. And Capablanca captured the knight, knight takes on c6. What a monster knight, what a massacre. And bishop takes on c6, but then rook from a to b1. Look at the rooks of Capablanca, aiming the king, targeting the king. A vicious attack, a vicious wild attack by Capablanca. A vicious wild attack by Capablanca. After rook from a to b1, we have queen to e8. Well, let's make a random move. Then bishop to f7, once again, is possible. And if capturing the bishop, then queen takes on c6. The pawn is picked. Defending the checkmate threat. But here comes rook takes on b6, checking the king, What else? And then queen takes on b6. If moving the king, then queen takes on d8. If not moving the king, then queen takes on d8. And white has a perfect attack, an incredible attack in this position. And black is losing. After moving the king, rook to c7 is possible. So let's take it back. So in this position, black has to be careful. We have queen to e8. And Capablanca played bishop to b5. And Thomas Downey played bishop to d6. And Capablanca captured the bishop. Bishop takes on c6. And black resigned. In this position, he paid the price for not showing respect to Capablanca. He was extremely confident, but no, he paid the price. Black is losing, and black can't capture the bishop. If capturing the bishop, we have this funny continuation, queen takes on c6, and the pawn is pinned. Well, in this position, if bishop takes on b5, then queen takes on c7, moving the king, and queen to a5, checking the king, moving the king, and rook takes on b5, and black is losing once again. So in the real game, after bishop takes on c6, black resigned. And if defending the queen, then rook takes on b7, checking the king, king to c8, queen to a4, a random move, and then queen to a8, checkmate. There is no defense, and black is getting crushed. Black is getting destroyed. What an incredible chess game by Capablanca, once again. An incredible chess game. He mesmerized the crowd in England and also the chess players. With his brilliancy in 1911 when he visited England. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye-bye.